sorry, I don't understand.
I don't understand.
We tried our best, Mrs. Asian, but her injuries were too severe.
Aww.
No, I don't understand. I was just talking to her.
I'm afraid Jennifer passed away before we could get to her in surgery. We did the best we could. I'm so sorry.
Where is she? Let me see her.
Please, Mrs. Asian, take a seat.
I don't want to take a seat. Let me talk to her. Now.
I'll arrange for you to see her. In the meantime, James is in recovery. He's stable for now.
I don't want to see him.
I don't want to see him. You're standing in the hallway. Something has that stopped you in your tracks. While searching your mind, your sister interrupts. She waves her hand in front of you and asks if you can drive her home. You still feel out of sorts, those words echo. All those drinks we had, and now we're going to drive her home, and that's how the accident happens. And just finally, when the whole family was so proud of me. She's waiting patiently for that ride home you had promised her. Can we go upstairs now? You'd love to call it a night, but Jen is waiting patiently. You need to tell me which room you want to go to. It won't let me go anywhere else, will it? Maybe your keys are in the kitchen. The kitchen is busy. Way too many people crammed in here, but I guess this is where the food and drink are at. The guests are like a set of vultures picking at the roast on the kitchen counter. Your dad is locking up the utility room. Go to utility room. Don't understand. Guests. Look around. It's difficult to move around in here between all the people and the kitchen table. Looking at the table didn't work before. The table is a mess. Party food mixed, unclaimed drinks, used napkins, no keys though. This probably won't work. Okay, go to living room. Oh, I need to exit first. Why don't you understand? You are standing back out in the hallway, bottle of whiskey in hand, but no car keys. Jen points to the living room and sighs as she puts on her coat. This is horrible. This is one of those things where you're playing the game. You sure your keys are in the living room. The living room has a more relaxed atmosphere compared to the kitchen. Various guests are sat on the chairs having civilized conversations. There's a coffee table in the middle of the room. Your mum is pouring a drink at the drinks cabinet. This is one of those games where you're seeing something, right? But it's interactive. So in a way, you know, you're killing that person. I am going to end up with no other choice than to get in the car and end up crashing and killing her. Mom, she's totally in her element here. She always loved being the host. Well, I guess this is English. Talk to Mom. Tears immediately start to appear in her eyes. My son, off to America. She gives you a hug. Can I talk to Dad, then? Right. Empty-handed, you head back out into the hall. I just want to see if Dad would have anything to say. Dad tells you to take your sister home. But to go slow since you've had a few drinks already. Yup. Yeah, yeah, we can talk in the car. Go get your keys. And says... living room. Okay, so we've got a coffee table and a drink. A drinks cabinet. That cabinet. Your mum's collection of wines and spirits. Definitely no keys in here. This probably won't work. Oops. Definitely won't work that way. Friends in conversation. Jackets and coats everywhere. Maybe want someone's coat, but let's look at the table. Drinks on coasters, like proper civilized people. You can't see your keys. Look. Coats. Sorry, I don't know what you're looking at. Look. Jack. Maybe it is upstairs. She says it's in there. Alright, apparently it's really in there. Sure, your keys are in the living room. So... look under coats. Ask mum for keys. Is it my... I'm assuming it's my car. You take a look underneath. No keys. Look under... table. Same. Look... around. One of the chairs is overflowing with jackets and coats. Look under chair. No keys. Look under cabinet. Ask mum about keys. I just want to see something. Yep. Even if it doesn't recognize it, it will give you that response. You have to type in the one line that it's looking for. Well, you've got guests. Unless one of them has the keys. You've got chairs. You've got a coffee table. Be under. Maybe I'll look in cabinet. Definitely no keys in here. Jen, I can't find the keys. Guess you'll have to look. Look in pocket. So it's evidently look under something. So it probably didn't recognize it. look in coat pockets. You search through all the jackets and coats until you find yours. Aha! Car keys in the pocket. You grab both. Oh, I guess both the key and the jacket. Look at the keys. The keys to the car. You're missing some punctuations there. I found them again. Alright, exit. Keys in hand, you head back into the hall. Jan thanks you for helping her out. She has work in the morning, and no one else is in any fit state to drive. Neither are we. You can handle it, though. You know the road like the back of your hand, don't you? No. I don't know crap. Hold on a second. I got hair bothering me. Alright, so... talk to Jen. She thanks you for taking her home, even if it has taken you ages to find your keys. You're welcome. I'm not gonna thank you by killing you. Go outside. You open the front door and walk out into the freezing night. The cold air hits you. You are glad you have your jacket with you. There is a dusting of snow around you as you step down from the porch. The yard extends around the back of the house, and the car sits at the front of the house. Snow. Go to yard. She sighs and comically taps her feet. Apart from the little light escaping from the party indoors, the yard is pitch black. You used to love stargazing here. You stumble around the darkness looking for the perfect spot to take in the majesty of the night sky. Is the generator here? The trusty old generator is here working away. The sky is majestic. Turn off generator. While that would be a hilarious prank, you think better of plunging the house into darkness. Guess these guys have no electricity, no electric power lines. Always this generator? They don't last that long, do they? You need to keep refilling it with fuel, but... You gaze up in the night sky. For some reason, you don't recognize any of the star patterns tonight. I know, I'm just putting off the inevitable at this point. Light peeks through the curtains from the party indoors. Dad's done a good job of maintaining this place. Alright. I don't know what else to do. Go to driveway. Jennifer looks relieved as you head back round to the front of the house. The cold air hits you. You're glad you have your jacket with you. Blah, blah, blah. And yet, we went back to the house and the door closed again. If I take so long, I'll sober up, right? The family station wagon. So many memorable road trips in it. Go to... warn Jen. Talk to Jen. She needs to get home, but she also wanted a final bit of brother and sister time before you leave. Okay. Hug Jen. Okay. She does, but she's not saying anything. I guess that's in the past. She had that time. You fumble with the car handle, confused, until Jen tells you to maybe use the key in your hand. Like, this isn't a warning to her? I'm not even using the right key. And I'm supposed to drive her all the way home safely. Turn the car keys, you eventually get the door open and climb inside. The car is freezing. As you fumble around with your seatbelt, your sister opens up the car glove box and hands you a note and a key that was inside. She tells you that it's for when you return. And that's something that actually never works in, like, interactive fiction games, typing use, because it's kind of a cheat, because you don't, even if they find something, like some machine you don't know how to use, you type use and it would mysteriously start working. Use usually doesn't work in games like this. Read note. The note is from your dad and reads, "Hi son, hope you enjoy your break. You'll need to fire up the generator around back to get the power and lights on. Also, I found something in the attic for you. It's in your room. Enjoy." There's that note. Both you and Jen have your seatbelts on and are ready to go. It's time to go. The keys. One for the car and now one for the front door. Handy for later, maybe. Seat belts. Okay, exit car. Jennifer is getting impatient. If you value your life, you better get her home first. If she values her life, she better just let me sleep it off. Start car. You try to turn the ignition with sheer willpower, despite holding keys in your hand. Use keys. It takes a number of attempts, but you eventually slot the key into the ignition. Jen's getting plenty of warnings here. Bah. See, now I'm so drunk I can't type. Start. Car. You turn the key in the ignition, and the car roars to life. One last time. She stares. Really? Move. Alright, move. Okay. Drive. The car squeals but stays stationary. Jin suggests releasing the brake, giving you a wide-eyed stare. I'm trying to warn her. Press gas. Use gas pedal. Turn wheel. Release. Brake. You very hesitantly release the handbrake. Turn. Drive. You put the car in gear and pull out the driveway like a first-time driver. You really shouldn't be driving. I am driving, very drunk on the road towards the town where your sister stays. Jen started dozing off as soon as the journey gets going. This shouldn't take long. You come to a junction. Is it left or right? You can't remember. I was afraid the text was gonna, like, wipe. Left? I'm sorry, I don't understand. Turn left. You don't want to, but you better ask Jen for directions. There's no time for that right now. She seems startled by both your erratic driving and inability to remember the way to her house. Yeah, warning! Warning! Danger! Danger, Will Robinson! Talk to Jen. She grunts and throws her arms to the left. It's left. Of course it's left. I was already turning left. Turn right. As you start to turn right, a startled Jen grabs the wheel. It's left, not right. C- Confident that you're on the right road now, you loosen up and put your foot down on the accelerator. You feel powerful as the engine roars at your command. Jen sits up in her chair and clutches your arm. She asks you to slow down. Slow down. That's not what really happened, though, is it?
You're all over the place, James. Pull over.
Jen is hitting your arm and yelling at you. Crazy sister. Strange. There's a set of headlights coming directly at you, but really slow. Like slow motion. Swerve. You try to react, but your body isn't responding. There's nothing you can do to stop this. There's no way to control it. The lights merge with your car. The outside joins the inside. The whole
James,
world around you
sake, pull over.
Begins to scream.
James!
It was at this very moment, wasn't it, James?
Can't type.
The moment you lost it all. Your sister. Your parents. Yourself. And then you made it worse. Go on. Show us what you did.
I made it worse? You wake up in the car. Your world is upside down. Your seatbelt struggles against gravity, trying to hold you in your seat. An impact into another car has torn a hole in the chassis. Poisonous fumes spill into your car from the engines. You are in grave danger. You have to get out of here. I left without her, didn't I? And then I took the whiskey and put it in the ex-cops, the retired policeman's, sorry, car to make it look like he was the one. But of course they can do an autopsy and find out if he had alcohol in his system, right? I can't see all the words here. Can I go like this and focus in what? Sorry, I don't know what you look. I clicked. And it acted as enter. Look at Jen. She's alive, but she's been hurt bad. She's trapped in the wreckage. Get Jen. You can't move the wreckage from around her. It would be too dangerous. Save yourself. Move. Wreckage. You can't move. That car shouldn't be there. You don't understand. The driver is slumped in his seat. I'm typing through glass shards here. Thankfully, your seatbelt is strapped around you, holding you in place. Jen. She's drifting in and out of consciousness. She's very weak. God damn it, game, let me do it. You can't move the wreckage. Blah, 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 blah. You release your seatbelt from the seat. Gravity takes over as you slump onto the roof of the car. Exit. You squeeze through the wreckage and fall to your knees on the ground next to your vehicle. Every breath brings pain to your chest. Your head is throbbing. A blue car has smashed into the passenger side of your car. Your life cannot be ruined by this. You're standing holding your whiskey and your dad's note, and flashing lights are approaching at a distance. The note, always changing, now reads, get through this, James. I don't care if you want to or not. You're a whiskey. The police cannot find you with this. Don't know what you're looking at. What car? The other blue car or yours? Look. Blue car. The hazard lights are blinking and fumes are rising from the engine. Through the smashed windows you can see the motionless driver. Why did he have his hazard lights on? Look at my My car. There's no going home in this. The symbols and writing on the car are barely visible anymore. I wish I could just get Jen. Get Jen. Look at the lights. I can't click that. Okay. It's not gonna let me advance. Go to blue car. The door is jammed. You don't have time for messing around like this, James. Do I just go like this? Put whiskey in blue car? With the lights approaching closer, you begin to hear the thrill, the shrill of their sirens. You simply cannot go to jail for this. You clean the bottle to remove your connection with the whiskey. You then very deliberately spill the remainder of the bottle's contents onto the driver, and you toss the incriminating evidence onto his passenger seat. I forget. Did he die? I guess he lived. A circle of flashing lights surround you, illuminating the crash site in the darkness. Behind them, an army of people all staring. One figure steps out, a silhouette, and walks toward you, like in the alien one, the second one. One figure steps out. So I guess the policeman, the retired policeman, lived? And it was as a DWI and, like, I guess manslaughter charges. Lights are overwhelming. All other details are fading into the past. You see visions of your sister as you look into the pulsating lights. Figure. The silhouette is a police officer and in uniform. He beckons you to approach. Talk to officer. You try to talk, but you are not making any sense. Go to officer. As you approach the man, the pulsating lights around you get dimmer and dimmer while the pain in your head increases.
I know you.
You fall to the ground at your feet.
You're tearing yourself apart over it, but no matter what you keep telling yourself, you have to listen to me.
Is that my mother?
That accident. That poor man. Me.
That's Jen.
You have to remember. It was all your fault.
Nice. I feel great now.
I know what you did. How you left me there to protect yourself.
Shouldn't have done that.
Planting evidence on some poor man.
Shouldn't have done that either.
You went headfirst into that officer and you wrecked all of our lives. And then you couldn't even take responsibility. You did the right thing for you and no one else. Save yourself. Only it was wrong, wasn't it? Look at you now. Utterly consumed by it.
Yep.
Say it, James.
Am I supposed to walk towards this thing or supposed to go this way?
Say it. Tell them.
Who am I telling? Something familiar about this bed. What they did to you.
Listen to yourself.
It has to end, James. Do you not understand?
It has to end, okay.
This episode you're having must come to an end. Make it stop, make it stop. Do you remember?
Oh, I got stuck on something. like police strobes.
Stop the session, Mr. Asian.
I'm not sure how.
Go back to where we started.
But that room? Where you were recording me?
Put an end to this nightmare. You can do this, James. You can let go.
Fire, fire! Observation room. What am I supposed to be doing? Sometimes they make you watch your past sessions to see what really happened. Well, I figured it was here I'm supposed to go. All of your episodes are recorded to tape. This is the fourth. Right. Chapter 4. I guess I don't go through there? Oh! I clicked that thing so many times.
Well, I think we've made progress today, Mr. Asian. I guess we should tell the police what you've told us. Although I don't suspect it'll take you anywhere. I think you'll be with us for quite some time. Come on, let's get you back to your shows. I'll see you tomorrow.
Wow. So what show is he actually watching? So what'd you guys think? I think it was very interesting. And I saw a lot of clues scattered throughout all the episodes. Probably a few that I didn't catch up on. Jennifer Asian. Officer Williams. No names that I recognize. Dr. Daniel Alexander. Mrs. Asian. Reporter. Thanks so much for watching, guys, and this is a long episode, too. So, obviously you'll see, but I'm not sure if I want to upload them as four episodes only, because those made some... The first one wasn't bad, because it was 40-something minutes, but the others were over an hour each. At least two of them were, so... I'll figure out what the hell I'm doing. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Hope to see you in another Let's Play. And always, seek adventure.